gets it back. Under 16 minutes of play. That one's stolen. Charlton has it. One-on-one. Euro step. Finger roll is good. 11-7. Fordham trails by four.
They're picking up full court here. This is going to throw some pressure on George Washington.
A little bit of man-to-man pressure in the backcourt, like you mentioned, Thomas. Charlton guarding Adams closely. He finally gets it over the timeline. Adams at the point, now at the left arc. Here's Adams. Dribble move into the paint. Stops. Kicks it out. Edwards, the freshman, at the right arc. Step back. Long two. It's good. Impressive basket there from Maximus Edwards, the freshman. Leading A-10 rookies in scoring with 10.8 points per game. It's 13-7. 15-20 to go in the first half. Charlton. Simbilla has checked in the game. He sets a screen for him. Charlton loses the handle for a moment, but gets it back. It's Quisenberry at the left arc. Now Simbilla at the top of the perimeter. Far corner. It's Charlton. He's going to try a triple off the front of the rim. Too short. Rebounded by Lindo. Here goes Adams for the Colonials the other way. Bounce pass to Dean off a pick and roll in the paint at the right block. He goes up, and it's going to be a jump ball. Antrell Charlton got his hand in the way there. Possession will remain with George Washington, but that's our first timeout in this one. It's 14:56 remaining in the first half. It's George Washington 13 and Fordham 7. You're listening to Fordham Rams basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hey everyone, Michael Calamari here, one of the beat reporters for this season's New York Knicks basketball team. Follow us all season on WFUV Sports, on our Twitter for game and player updates, and on our YouTube channel for a post-game recap following every home game. Also, keep an eye out for special reports on WFUVsports.org throughout the year. For all things New York Knicks basketball, follow WFUV Sports all season long.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Gym. Sam Davis alongside Thomas Aiello. It's 13-7. GW out in front of Fordham in the early going. And looking at the coaching staff for the visiting George Washington Colonials, and we've mentioned it before, but it's first-year head coach Chris Caputo. He's led GW to their best A-10 start at 5-2 in 8 years. They had a tough overtime victory last time out against St. Joe's. Success, really nothing new to Coach Caputo. Previously coached for 19 years with Jim Larrañaga between Miami and George Mason. He was a part of their Elite Eight run last season with Miami. Really a talented coach who's already done a lot with this program early on.
And Caputo was also on their George Mason squad when they went to the Final Four with Jim Larrañaga,
yes.
Right? One of the things he's seen is a lot of things, right? He's been to a Final Four, an Elite Eight. He's coached NBA players, Shane Larkin, Bruce Brown, Lonnie Walker, right? DeJuan Hernandez, who went to the NBA. Chris Likes, who was a transfer last year for Arkansas. He knows what it takes to play at a high level, especially in the ACC. Chris Caputo coming to George Washington. Like I said, this is the best that this team has looked since Carl Hobbs was at GW way back in the 2000s when they were going to the NCAA. They were winning the A-10 consistently. They were A-10 regular season champions. And the one thing I see similarity-wise between those two eras, they had really good guards. Now, these guys, Bishop, Edwards, really good offensive guards. But for Carl Hobbs, great defensive guards. Carl Elliott had 2 steals per game with George Washington when he was there. But a lot of those elements are coming back, and that's what Foggy Bottom thrives on, this fast break, small ball, offensive-minded team. And it's really found them a ton of success.
It's going to be Bishop inbounding underneath the basket on the baseline. Lobs it up to Dean, who catches it. Snatches it down, holds it at his hip, passes it underneath the basket. Bishop, and an easy layup. 2 more points for GW. Nice play coming out of the timeout. 15-7. They lead. 14:45 to go in the first half. Charlton has it at the right arc. Here's Moore at the top of the perimeter. Ball fake. Passing along to Quisenberry. Quisenberry off a high screen. All the way to the hoop, and the layup is pure. It's 15-9. GW up 6. Here's Bishop the other way. For the Colonials, at the left arc, crossover, cross-court pass. It's Harris, another cross-court pass. GW moving it around. Here's Edwards into the paint. The finger roll, just a little too strong. The tip back, it's going to be a goaltending call. It was in the cylinder as Lindo tried to tip that one back. So it's a stop for the Rams defensively. 15-9, they trail.
Well, Maximus Edwards, the transfer from Kansas State, really is a Big 12 talent. his athleticism so far ahead of a lot of the guards in the Atlantic 10, but right there it worked against his advantage in the offensive goaltending.
Maximus Edwards spent his final 2 years of high school at Our Savior Lutheran School in the Bronx, just 2.5 miles away from Fordham. So kind of a homecoming for him here. Hands it off. Here's Quisenberry at the right elbow. Now backs up right arc three off the side rim. Moore tries to grab the miss, but he cannot. Here goes Bishop. Has it poked away by Rose. Moore picks it up one-on-one into the paint. He has it knocked away out of bounds. And it looks like a foul will be called. So active hands by Rose on defense. That's what Kyle Rose does. He really is a menace on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, I was going on Twitter this morning, and some of the tweets were about Kyle Rose for Atlantic 10 Defensive Player of the Year, Kyle Rose for All A-10 Defense. I think rightfully so. Now, he is struggling shooting the basketball as of late. His numbers have dipped 34% from three, 34% from the field as well. But what he's always going to bring you is defensive effort every single game, and that's critical for this Fordham team.
Khalid Moore hits the first free throw. He had 19 points last game against St. Bonaventure, second on the team in scoring, second on the team in rebounding. He's been right there and a huge offensive addition for Fordham. The grad student coming from Georgia Tech has really stepped up, was a role player with them. Second shot is good as well. His previous career high was 19 points at Georgia Tech, excuse me, in 4 years. He's had 19 points or more in 6 games this season alone. So really taking a step up offensively for the Rams. Both free throws are knocked down, so it's 15-11. Fordham trails by four with 13:45 remaining in the first half. Here's Bishop right at the Fordham logo. Off a high screen, hesitation into the paint. It's blocked by Simbila, but it's a goaltending call. Bishop with a hesitation move to the basket. The speed and quickness has been really impressive in the early going here.
The head fake is one of my favorite moves in all of basketball. If you can execute it, it's so effective. James Bishop baited Abdu Simbila. I thought he had a pin to the backboard, but instead it's an offensive goal. It's a goaltend, rather, but a great move by James Bishop. That's one you acquire, those hot, sweaty July afternoons in the gym. That one is just all work.
James Bishop had 25 points last year against Fordham. These two teams played each other twice, and they split their meetings. Fordham won at home, and GW won at home. As it's advanced over the half-court line, Rose, entry pass to Nowitzki at the extended left block. Here's Nowitzki, faces up, kicks it out. Rose, pump fake, drives all the way to basket, goes up, misses the layup. Nowitzki with the tip back, can't get it to go. Rebounded by Lindo, a couple of close opportunities for Fordham to score. They cannot. It's 17-11. They trail by six. 13 minutes to go in the first half. Harris into the lane and now out of it. Here's Bishop at the top of the key. He takes a three. It's way too short. Rebounded by Quisenberry. Little heat checks for James Bishop, who now has 6 points. Quisenberry hands it off to Richardson at the right arc. Here's Rose at the left wing. Entry pass again to Nowitzki at the left block. Goes to work. Here's Nowitzki. Spins in the paint. Puts it up with the left hand. He's fouled and will head to the line for two. Thomas, you talked about it before the game. Fordham really exploiting their advantage in the paint. They're doing it right there.
Well, Noel Brown, he's a nice player. Good backup center for GW. But he doesn't get the minutes that maybe a guy like Nowitzki or Abdu Simbila, Daron Holmes, Francis Okoro from St. Louis, that those guys get. So he's not in the game all the time. He's not used to the physicality. Fordham weaponizes that to their advantage. That is well short. Wow.
Nowitzki missed that first free throw. He did struggle from the line last game against St. Bonaventure. Really missed a couple of important free throws down the stretch in that one. Seems like maybe that's a little bit in his head here, as we'll be at the line for one more shot.
That's funny to me because he hit a three earlier, and now we can't shoot free throws.
Sometimes that's how it is.
That's a really screwed up math equation. There you go.
The second free throw is up and good, and Nowitzki now with 6 points on the day. He leads Fordham scorers. James Bishop with six, leading the way for GW. It's 17-12 with 12:45 to go in the first half. It's going to be at that. Adams advancing it over the timeline on the far side of the court. Guarded by Quisenberry. Adams shakes his defender. Deep left arc three. He nails it. Brendan Adams from a mile away hits that one. It's 20-12. GW up in front. Here's Richardson. The freshman trying to answer. Shimmies into the paint as it knocked away out of bounds. Possession will remain with Fordham.
That was a deep, deep three from Brendan Adams. That was Steph Curry range. Almost at the hash mark. Just pulled it with no hesitation. I'm starting to question the shot selection for both teams, but I guess if it goes in, we'll let it slide.
Brendan Adams, the most improved scorer in the A-10. Bounce pass in to Quisenberry. The layup is in. 20-14, a good play off of the inbounds from the Rams and a quick basket. Here's Adams bringing it up for GW. Averaged just 8.5 points per game last year, now averaging almost 18 points per game. Really taking a step up. Pass into the middle. It's Samuel, straight on three. It's too short. Rose snags the rebound, and he loses it, pushing in transition. Here's Bishop into the paint. Bounce pass underneath. Going up is Brown, and he's going to be fouled. So a turnover for Fordham. GW is able to get to the line and force some free throws. It's 20-14. The Colonials up in front of the Fordham Rams with 11:51 remaining in the first half. We're going to go back to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one scoreboard with Owen Kelty.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Starting off in the A-10, LaSalle and Rhode Island just tipped off. Later today, Richmond heads to Dayton, Duquesne plays UMass, and St. Bonaventure goes to VCU. For top 25 play, number 7, Virginia routes Boston College 76-57, West Virginia upset number 15, Auburn 80-77, and Creighton upsets number 13, Xavier 84-67. For the later slate of top 25 play, number 2, Alabama plays Oklahoma, number 12, Iowa State takes on Missouri, and Cincinnati travels to take on number 3, ranked Houston. Capping off a big day for top 25 basketball is a huge rivalry game between number 9, Kansas, and unranked Kentucky at 8 p.m. Over in this association, we have another big rivalry game between the Knicks and the Nets in Brooklyn at 5:30. And at 8:30, the Lakers will ship up to Boston as LeBron James chases the NBA scoring record. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Owen Kelty.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Gym. Sam Davis alongside Thomas Aiello here with 90.7 FM WFUV Sports. Fordham basketball, it's 20-14. George Washington over the Rams here with 11:51 remaining in the first half. And Thomas, in this one, we've seen some really, really impressive work, of course, from Brennan Adams and James Bishop. That's exactly what we expected. But Fordham has been able to hang around. They've been known for getting off to slow starts in A-10 games early on. But today, they're hanging right in there with GW, a team that normally gets off to a very hot start.
Well, Fordham defensively is a little different than some of the teams that George Washington has seen as of late, right? St. Joseph's defensively, not that great of a team. Some of those other teams that they've played, not that great, but Fordham is a whole different beast because they're so physical, right? But Fordham offensively, their offense starts very slow, as you mentioned, but it's Rostik Nowitzki right now carrying the load off on that side. 6 points, he hit a three. We haven't seen him do that enough this year, but Quisenberry is 2 of 6 from the field. He does have 4 points. The shot selection is driving me up a wall. Why would you take a fast break three-pointer? Just go right to the basket. Don't try to overcomplicate everything. Just make the simple play. That's what Fordham has to do in these next few minutes. Just execute the simple play and just try to tread water here.
Fordham looking to win their fourth straight game. Same thing with GW. They're both coming in off win streaks in this one. Fordham 16-4 on the year as Brown is at the line for two shots. The first one rattles in and out. He'll have one more free throw. Fordham eclipsing their win total, or equaling their win total that they had all of last year and still over a month to play, showing the job that Coach Ergo has done with this team in year one at the head coaching position. The second shot is good. It's 21-14. Richardson will bring the ball up for the Rams, moving right to left. At the top of the perimeter, now at the right arc, passing it to Moore. Holds it over his head. Shovels it off to Quisenberry. Lobs it to Moore at the left wing. He looks to drive baseline and does. At the left block, here's Moore. Going to work. Pump fakes, gets the layup, misses it. Had a wide open layup, couldn't get it in. And a missed opportunity for Fordham. Bishop in transition for GW. He has his shot blocked by Khalid Moore. So a good job after missing the layup on one end, hustling back on defense, getting the block on the other end.
Well, you can't smoke those layups. It was wide open. No one was there to contest it. Got a little too excited, but defensively, Khalid Moore makes up for it. That's where he was really good at Georgia Tech, and he's added that here at Fordham.
Here's Brown in the near corner, hands it off to Adams. Adams will drive baseline. He goes up off the backboard, and he will be fouled. Brennan Adams drawing some contact, heading to the charity stripe for two shots. He leads all scorers with 8 points in the early going.
Talked about Brennan Adams again being unlocked in this Chris Caputo offensive system. Last year under Jamie and Christian, sort of like a role player, averaged around 8 points per game. really was confused as to what he was really good at, but this year Caputo told him just shoot the basketball, and it's worked out pretty well so far, I'd say.
Adams hits the first free throw, the transfer from UConn. And Bishop, a lot of times drawn a double team against a lot of teams, and Coach Ergo talked about how his ability to really pass out of that, find his open teammate, and a lot of times that's been Brendan Adams, who is second on the team in scoring, but fifth in the conference. As the second free throw rattles out, it's 22-14. So an 8-point lead for the Colonials with 11 minutes to play in the first half. Richardson, crossover dribble, bounce pass at the top of the circle, Moore. Now at the left elbow, hands it off to Richardson. Richardson, double team, puts up the mid-range jumper. It's off the backboard, no good. Will Richardson held scoreless so far in this one. Here's Adams. Crossover move, splits the lane. He goes up, misses the layup. Elijah Gray, the freshman, snatches the rebound down. Hands it to Quisenberry. Fordham out and running. At the top of the point, here's Quisenberry. Off a screen, mid-range jumper, no good. Rebounded by Edwards. Edwards passing it ahead to Adams. Hesitation, cross-court pass. Caught by Bishop, guarded very closely by Moore. Here's Bishop holding it at his hip. Now guarded by the freshman Dean. Lobbing it into the paint, a mismatch and an easy slam for Noel Brown, guarded by Quisenberry down there in the right block. He makes him pay.
Well, they saw the mismatch. James Bishop was patient to wait for it. Fed him at the right time, and the big man punishes the guard.
24-14, GW up 10 with 10 minutes to play in the first half. Here's Quisenberry holding it at his hip, driving into the lane. Bounce pass Gray underneath the basket. Scoop layup is good. Elijah Gray on the board, 24-16.
Elijah Gray has really good footwork underneath, still trying to find his way as a freshman, but he's got a nice post game, and that's going to take him a long way in the future.
Gray had 7 points and 4 rebounds last game against St. Bonaventure, getting on the board here early on. Bishop pump fakes, passes it to Brown. He goes up, has his shot blocked. Loose rebound. Richardson has it. He'll look to push it and passes it up ahead to Moore. Moore at the left arc. Passing it underneath the basket. Dean was lost. He gets the floater to go. It's 24-18. Fordham with back-to-back baskets.
Roma Dean, same thing, but extremely athletic. Sometimes it can work against him, but he was able to stop himself and get a free layup underneath.
Another freshman, Roma Dean. Coach Ergo trusting these freshmen with big minutes in every single game this year. And a big A-10 matchup between Fordham and GW. Samuels at the right arc tries a three. It's too strong. And Edwards tries to save it, throws it out of bounds, and Fordham will have possession. The crowd getting into it here at the Rose Hill Gym. A sold-out Rose Hill Gym, 24-18 GW up ahead of Fordham.
Well, it really does feel like the mid-2000s, way back in the day, when both of these teams were very good in the Atlantic 10. Head-to-head, offense versus defense, these guys are going at it, and there's a huge crowd here today as well. It really feels like those olden days of Fordham A-10 hoops.
One of the bigger games Fordham's had at home in a number of years. Some subs are checking in. It's Quisenberry is going to take a breather here.
I like that move. He's been off. He's not hitting his shots. 2 of 7 from the field. Sit him down. Let him catch his breath. Then maybe he'll turn it on once he comes back.
Darius Quisenberry has been 14% from three in the last 5 games. He's really struggled from behind the arc. Still providing a lot of points for the Rams, especially at the free throw line. As Moore has it at the top of the circle, he takes a mid-range jumper. It's good. Khalid Moore faces his defender and nails the two-pointer. It's 24-20. Fordham, a mini 6-0 run here with 8:40 to go in the first half. Here's Adams. Denies the screen, passing into the far corner. Harris, he pump fakes through the legs dribble. Still has it in the corner. Loses it for a moment, but gets it back and then lobs it back out to Adams. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Adams. Pump fakes. Takes a deep contested three. It's too short. But Edwards is right there for the rebound. He puts up the floater. It's in. And Edwards for two. It's 26-20. GW up 6.
That was a bad box out by Fordham. That's something they really haven't been able to do, is just boxing out the open guy. It's a small, small detail, but that one especially goes a long way.
Under 8 minutes to play in the first half. It's 26-20. George Washington up over Fordham. Moore drives baseline in the left block, tries a cross-court pass in the far corner. It's Rose. He has it. Rose through the legs, dribble. Now bounce pass into Moore in the right block. Moore spins, puts up the floater. It's fouled. Khalid Moore will be at the line. A little bit of a push there from Lindo as both teams are starting to jaw as tempers. Things get a little interesting here. It's 26-20. George Washington over Fordham. 7:45 to go. Both sides will head towards their bench. As things are getting physical and things are getting interesting here in the Rose Hill Gym, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back with more Fordham basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hi, my name is Ryan Rucco, WFUV class of 2008. WFUV is your home for all things Fordham athletics, with live coverage of Fordham football, Fordham men's and women's basketball, in addition to our Saturday show, One-on-One. Stay right here on 90.7 FM for all things WFUV sports.
George Washington over Fordham with 7:45 remaining in the first half. And tempers starting to flare a little bit there as we head to break. And that's what happens with both teams really vying for very high positions in the A-10. And obviously the crowd plays a factor as well, really hyping up the Rams. A nice little run for them there. Thomas, what'd you see in the last couple of minutes allowing Fordham to work their way back into this game?
Well, I think for Fordham, it's more about going to guys maybe that aren't on the top of the scouting report, right, that are on top of George Washington's. We got to stop this guy. The second thing is sitting Darius Quisenberry down. Now, he's a volume shooter, loves to shoot the ball a lot, but he can pass the ball. He's got 3 assists today. Sitting him down, letting him catch his breath, just sort of mentally resetting, right? That's sort of how you get the most out of your players. We see it on the women's side for Fordham. Anna DeWolf, when she sits down for a little bit, she comes back in. She goes on like a 6-point run by herself. For Quisenberry, this could be a good move for him because he can maybe give you a 6-point burst by himself when he comes back in. The other thing I'm really looking forward at, or looking for as well, Fordham needs to go to the basket and draw more fouls. Mm. They are tops in the Atlantic 10. They hit the third most free throws in the A-10, third most attempted at the third highest clip. Play to your strengths, play inside. Draw the fouls, like I said, on this weak inside GW team. You can take advantage of their lack of size because they're going to bite for pump fakes, they're going to bite, they're going to reach, and you can get free throws out of that. Put them in the penalty and give yourself some free points when they foul you on dead ball fouls.
And Thomas, part of the reason why they had success last game against St. Bonaventure is that they got to the line so many times. They were at the free throw line. They made 25 free throws. That was a season high for them. Darius Quisenberry alone hit 11 free throws in that game. So even when he's struggling scoring and efficiently scoring, he can still draw some contact, get to the line. Fordham is a good free throw shooting team, and that's where they are at the charity stripe right now. It's going to be Khalid Moore at the line for 2 shots. We mentioned second on the team in scoring and rebounding. 19 points, 6 of 7 from the field last game against St. Bonaventure. Does a really good job absorbing contact. Has had a lot of big and ones the last couple of games in this Fordham win streak. First shot at the line is up and good. Both teams shoot from the free throw line very well. They're second and third in the A-10. They're both top 45 in the NCAA as well with free throw percentage. So it'll be very important to draw some contact in this one.
Well, Khalid Moore spent a couple of years playing against Mark Williams and Paolo Banchero and all those big boys in the ACC. He's not scared of anything in the Atlantic 10.
Moore hits both free throws. It's 26-22. The Rams trailing by 4 with 7:30 remaining in the first half. Here's Adams, crossover move, drives into the paint, tries to pass it out, deflected, but eventually gets into the hands of Harris, near corner. He tries a 3, it's too short, rebounded by Moore. And a stoppage here, it looks like that's Adams coming up limping. Not what you want to see for really anybody. Such a talented guard, we talked about him a lot already, Brendan Adams, 9 points in this game. He is limping on his own power, but towards the bench. Might be some sort of ankle injury there.
Well, let's hope he's okay. Because if you can walk off the floor on your own power, even if you're limping, you're a tough customer. That's a good sign.
Definitely a positive sign to see him walking off, as Fordham will have possession now. It's 26-22. Trailing by 4. 7:20 to go in the first half. Charlton Bounce pass to Moore at the top of the perimeter. Here's Moore. Ball fake. Drives towards the right block. Has it knocked away and stolen. Edwards has it. GW out and running. Here's Edwards at the left arc. Cross-court pass in the near corner. Harris. He drives baseline. Now pulls it back out. Here's Edwards at the right wing. Edwards. Jab step. Puts up a deep three. It's an air ball. Fordham will just let that one go out of bounds. The student section here lets Maximus Edwards hear it. The freshman, an ill-advised shot there, an air ball, and Fordham will have possession.
Now, Maximus Edwards, offensively last game, 12 points and 10 rebounds. He is a weapon, but that was a terrible shot. Going for the jab step usually can create some space, but he was a couple feet behind the arc. I would have liked to have seen him maybe go off of the dribble.
Edwards had his second double-double of the year last game against St. Joe's, 12 and 10, as Moore holds the ball over his head and has it at the point. Passing it to Rose. Rose off the screen. Here's Charlton swinging it to Quisenberry. Back to Charlton. Straight on. Triple off the side rim. Gray tries to grab the miss, but he cannot. Lindo comes down with it, the leading rebounder for GW at 7 rebounds a game. Here's Adams back into the game. Immediately check back in. A good sign for GW. Here's Bishop. Hesitation. Drives into the paint. Dishes it off to Dean. Ball fake, and he gets the layup in. Pretty offensive set there from George Washington. It's 28-22. They lead by 6. Quisenberry will bring it up across the logo here at the Rose Hill Gym with 6 minutes to go in the first half. It's 28-22. Back and forth action. Seen GW lead for the majority of this first period. Rose, through the legs dribble, driving into the paint, puts it up, off the glass, rolls out. Rebounded by Edwards. Here's Bishop the other way. James Bishop, off a screen from Dean. Loses it. Charlton picks it up. A turnover for GW. Passing it up ahead, and Charlton turns it right back over as Lindo intercepted that pass. He works it up ahead to Edwards. Driving into the paint. Has it knocked away. Sloppy back and forth possessions here. Another turnover, this time for GW. And Fordham will slow it down with 5:20 remaining in the first half. It's 28-22. The Rams trailing by 6. Quisenberry at the top of the arc, off a screen, right elbow, jump shot, off the glass, no good, but looks to track down his own miss, cannot. Here's Adams for George Washington. Bishop will have it at the Fordham logo, holds it over his head, now at his hip, guarded by Rhodes. Bishop in the near corner, still holding onto it, lobs it to Dean, swinging it around. Here's Lindo handing it off to Adams, a deep contested three, way too short, rebounded by Gray. Here's Elijah Gray, coast to coast, tries to put it up, deflected out of bounds, and possession will remain with Fordham. 4:41 left here in the first half. It's 28-22, George Washington up 6.
Elijah Gray has given Fordham some good minutes, but not sure he's ready to play point center just yet. I'd rather see him make the outlet pass and just run the floor. You got enough guards and guys out there who can dribble. If he gets to the spot, he would have had a free layup.
Elijah Gray getting some big minutes early on here as Moore spins in the paint and gets a layup in. Khalid Moore with an impressive move to the basket. It's 28-24. The Rams trailing by 4 with 4:30 to go in the first half. Here's Adams. Working it over the center line. Now has it. Lobs it to Dean. Here's Samuels at the right arc. Samuels holds it at his hip. Looks around trying to find somebody to pass it to. Still looking, finally hands it off to Edwards. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Edwards, swarming defense from the Fordham Rams. 2 seconds on the shot clock and one. Puts up the runner off the backboard, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. Coach Ergo's fired up with his team with a big defensive effort there. 28-24, the Rams will have possession.
I think Keith Ergo is going to be sweating at halftime. It's going to look like he just played the way this guy's running around the sidelines. Look at the energy. You can feel it in the Rose Hill Gym.
Definitely feel that energy from the sold-out Rose Hill Gym here. A lot of excitement around this team, and rightfully so, with 3 straight victories all coming on the road, 4-3 in the conference, having an opportunity to move up to third place in the A-10. They do win this one. It's 28-24. GW up 4, now under 4 minutes to play in the first half. Richardson at the point. Now at the right arc, passing it to Pat Kelly. Holds it above his head, hands it off to Quisenberry. Quisenberry, here's Simbila. Now Richardson at the far corner. Richardson drives baseline. Mid-range jumper, back rim. Simbila tries to tip it up on the offensive rebound, but tips it over the head of Richardson out of bounds, and that's going to lead to our final media timeout of the first half. It's 3:38 remaining, 28-24 GW over Fordham. Let's go back to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one scoreboard with Owen Kelty.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Starting off in the A-10, LaSalle leads Rhode Island 37-29. Later today, Richmond heads to Dayton, Duquesne plays UMass, and St. Bonaventure goes to VCU. For top 25 play, number 7 Virginia routes Boston College 76-57. West Virginia upsets number 15 Auburn 80-77, and Creighton upsets 13 Xavier 84-67. For the later slate of top 25 play, number 2 Alabama plays Oklahoma, number 12 Iowa State takes on Missouri, and Cincinnati travels to take on number 3 ranked Houston. Capping off a huge day for top 25 basketball is a huge rivalry game between number 9 Kansas and unranked Kentucky at 8 p.m. Over in the association, we have another big rivalry game between the Knicks and the Nets in Brooklyn at 5:30. And at 8:30, the Lakers will ship up to Boston as LeBron James chases the NBA scoring record. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Owen Kelty.
Sam Davidson, Thomas Aiello back at the Rose Hill Gym, 28-24, GW still up 4. And while they've been leading for the majority of this first half, Fordham, in the last couple of minutes, really picking up the intensity on the defensive side of the ball, getting some big-time stops, and they're able to turn that into some offense on the other end.
Well, for Fordham, it's all about running, right? Keith Ergo took out Rostik Nowitzki, took out Abdu Simbila, threw Khalid Moore at the stretch 4, and Elijah Gray was playing some 5. They went with a much more mobile lineup, able to create some more fast break opportunities, albeit both teams only have 4 fast break points. But Fordham is also sacrificing some size on the glass as well, losing the rebounding battle 19-12. They are down 4. Now, that is a concern, but if you're Fordham, you want to try and outpace George Washington. That's not something that's very easy to do. These guys are 100th in the country in pace and adjusted tempo, according to KenPom. Fordham plays at a much slower pace, but you have to somehow outscore them. And this offensive group is really good, but you have to absolutely exploit them defensively.
And that's what makes this matchup so interesting, Thomas. Really a team that, like you said, plays a little bit slower versus one of the better A-10 offensive teams in the country, a team that plays very fast. And we're seeing somewhat of a low-scoring affair, around average here, with just 3:38 to go in the first half. It's 28-24 as George Washington will be back underway here. It's Bishop taking it over half court. He has 6 points in this one, 3 of 7 from the floor. Here's Bishop, guarded by Richardson. Right arc 3 off the screen, and he nails it. Bishop with an impressive 3-pointer there. He's up to 9 points, 31-24 GW in front.
James Bishop, that was a tough shot, but wow.
Impressive. Makes it look easy there from behind the arc. Quisenberry at the top of the key, passing it to Charlton. Richardson at the right arc. Here's Simbila, handing it off to Quisenberry. Quisenberry splits the lane at the A-10 logo, now puts up the layup, gets it in. Darius Quisenberry responds with a basket of his own. It's 31-26, Fordham trailing by 5, 2:45 remaining in the first half. Here's Bishop, just over the half-court line. The freshman Richardson being tasked with guarding him. Bishop throws it underneath. Lindo at the left block. And the layup finds the bottom of the basket, 33-26. GW back up 7, 2:28 remaining in the first half. Richardson over the logo here at the Rose Hill Gym at the left elbow. Now working his way into the paint. Bounce pass out to Quisenberry at the left arc. Here's Kelly. Now swinging it to Charlton in the far wing. Charlton, mid-range jumper off the side rim, rebounded by Edwards. Here goes Bishop. Now under 2 minutes to play in the first half. Bishop, hesitation all the way to the rack. Whoa. Gets the layup off the glass and in. Under 2 minutes to play. And a couple of baskets from James Bishop. It's 35-26. The Colonials up by 9 now. And Coach Ergo will call a timeout. That's not what you want to see coming out of the break there. Fordham just letting up some easy baskets for GW.
Well, James Bishop, first team All-Atlantic 10, probably going to be the end to his season when the awards come out. He had an awesome move on this near side lane, just goes up in the right side with the left hand, has the speed to beat anybody in the conference, and then lost the ball mid-flight, was able to dish it off to Ricky Lindo for a basket. I don't know how anyone can do that. It's just you have to have some sort of focus, and James Bishop is on a different level. He's just built differently.
I tell you, we saw Deron Holmes with Dayton coming to the Rose Hill gym, and James Bishop, this guy is right there at the top of the Atlantic 10 with any players in the entire conference. Very, very impressive with what we've seen from him so far in the first half. He's got 11 points. He averages 22 points, and to say that this is an average first half for him, his last game he had 22 points against St. Joe's, that's just an average game for James Bishop. He's been over 40 points twice this season.
And when you're able to put up those high point totals and still average 5 assists a game, that is a complete guard.
He's the only player in the country to average over 5 assists per game and 22 points per game. As Quisenberry tries a 3, that one rattles in and out, but Gray tracks down the board. Quisenberry goes up and he goes hard to the deck and is fouled. And the whistles will blow here, which means Darius Quisenberry will be at the line for 2 shots. A good look there from behind the arc, just couldn't get it to go, but credit to Elijah Gray. Actually, it might be a call against Fordham. Not sure where the call was there, but it is a violation against the Rams, which means GW will have it. So just a minute 30 to go in the first half. George Washington up 35-28. Dean into the post. Has it at the left block. Passes it out to Lindo at the extended left block. Underneath the basket. Easy 2 points there for Ricky Lindo. It's 37-28. GW up 9, going on a run here to end the first half. With just about a minute left. Bounce pass to Riley, who's checked in. Has it at the right arc. Riley loses it for a moment. Hands it to Quisenberry. Quisenberry holding it at his hip. Passing it in the far corner. It's Moore. Fakes a 3. Now looks to drive baseline. Moore steps out. Passes it to Quisenberry. Quisenberry at the right arc. Now at the top of the key. At the free throw line. Kicks it out. Charlton right arc 3. Too strong. Tracking down the rebound was Charlton off of the miss. But it's out of bounds. 46.6 seconds remaining. George Washington will have it. Up 37-28.
Well, Fordham's hit a rut. Darius Quisenberry is shooting the basketball, but it's not going in the basket. 4 of 11. Now he's got those 2 layups, but some of the shots he's taking those mid-range elbow jumpers, just not helping the team.
Bishop with a deep 3. It's off the front of the rim. Can't get it to go. Potential 2-for-1 opportunity. GW was going for there. Quisenberry will push it. Moore, far corner 3. He nails it. Khalid Moore with a big-time basket, 37-31. The Rams trail by 6.
Well, Fordham needed that.
The shot clock is off. 20 seconds remaining here in the first half. Adams will bring it over the half-court line. GW will have the final possession before halftime. Adams guarded by Quisenberry. Now under 10 seconds remaining in this first half. Passing into the far corner, Lindo. He fakes a 3, loses the ball. Charlton has it. Passing it up ahead to Moore. In transition, tomahawk slam at the buzzer. That's what an end to the first half. 37-33, Fordham trailing by 4.
That's how you end the first half. Get this crowd back involved in the Khalid Moore dunk and run. What a great find by Charlton, keeping his head up in transition, and Fordham is right back in this game.
As soon as Charlton picked up that ball, was able to find Moore in transition, and he did the rest, lighting up this crowd here at the Rose Hill Gym as we head to the half. It's 37-33, George Washington over the Fordham Rams. Let's go back to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one halftime report with Colin Loughran.
The one-on-one halftime report.
Hello and welcome to the one-on-one halftime report. The Fordham Rams trail the George Washington Colonials by a tally of 37-33. Along with Owen Kelty, I'm Colin Loughran, here to break down the first half of action and preview what the second act could have in store. George Washington came in today's contest entering with a 5-2 record in A-10 play. They started out hot, 5-7 from the field, and led 13-7 with less than 5 minutes into this game. They benefited from some really good ball movement early and often. Their shooting, not surprising at all, considering that they boast the A-10's best team shooting percentage. Fordham hung tough all throughout this first half. Khalid Moore with some big plays down the stretch. All things considering, Fordham should like where they are. But before we dissect any of it, here's Owen Kelty with the one-on-one scoreboard.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Starting off in the A-10, LaSalle leads Rhode Island 38-29 at the half. Later today, Richmond heads to Dayton, and Duquesne plays UMass, and St. Bonaventure goes to VCU. For top 25 play, number 7 Virginia routes Boston College 76-57. West Virginia upsets 15 Auburn 80-77, and Creighton upsets number 13 Xavier 84-67. For the later slate of top 25 play, number 2 Alabama plays Oklahoma, number 12 Iowa State takes on Missouri, and Cincinnati travels to take on number 3 ranked Houston. Capping off a big day for the top 25 basketball is a huge rivalry game between number 9 Kansas and unranked Kentucky at 8 p.m. Over in the association, we have another big rivalry game between the Knicks and Nets in Brooklyn at 5:30. And at 8:30, the Lakers will ship up to Boston as LeBron James chases the NBA scoring record. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Owen Kelty.
George Washington leads Fordham 37-33 at the half. James Bishop, the leading scorer for those Colonials, he has 11 points, 5 of 10 day from the field. The story for Fordham, though, Owen, has been Khalid Moore in this first half of action. 13 points for him, 4 of 6 from the field, a big three-pointer at the end of the half, as well as a big dunk. What does it say about this Fordham team that they can hang tough with a team like George Washington, especially considering they were firing on all cylinders from basically the opening tip?
It's very important for Fordham, especially when you look at the three-point shooting for them. They're 2 of 10 from three, which is not very good. But Khalid Moore has had a very good game, shooting 4 or 6 from the field, and it's keeping it close. And especially when you're not shooting the ball well from three, to be able to keep the score close at half and stay tight with a team that's shooting 51% from the field, I mean, that's very good.
Fordham getting outperformed on the glass. Ricky Lindo Jr. leading the Colonials in that regard. They have an advantage in terms of team play, 21-14 in terms of boards. Looking at what this win could mean for each side, the A-10 right now, kind of a hodgepodge of what's going on. VCU at the top, 7-1. George Washington not far off, 5-2 record, just below VCU and St. Louis. Fordham at 4-3. A win could mean big things for both of these sides. What do they have to do to get that W going forward, Owen?
They're going to need to play good defense, definitely slow down GW in the paint, especially since GW is also not shooting very well from three. But they're going to have to be good on defense and continue to shoot well from the field and just continue to play good basketball.
Looking at what Fordham has had cooking, Rostik Nowitzki, 6 points for him, 2 rebounds overall, both of them offensive rebounds, strangely enough. Khalid Moore, we mentioned, with the 13 points. Darius Quisenberry, 8 points of his own today, but rather inefficient. 4 of 11 from the field, 0 of 3 from three-point range. This is something that I have chagrined about for the last couple of games from Darius Quisenberry. You can't be this inefficient. You are the team's leading man. You signed up to be the team's leading man. Even last year when Shuba Ohams was here running that center position so well, Quisenberry was the main force of scoring for these Rams. He needs to be more efficient going forward. You can't rely on other guys to get everything done offensively, especially not Khalid Moore. Because once teams realize that Khalid Moore is Khalid Moore, they're going to start throwing doubles. They're going to start throwing different defensive looks. Quisenberry has to step it up. What do you think a man like Quisenberry needs to do to get going? How do you get a shooter going would be my question, just in general.
Well, you could always say take more shots, but right now that's not working.
Oh, you want him to shoot out of it.
Yeah, well, you could let him shoot out of it, or you could help him. I mean, if other guys keep getting the ball and getting open, like especially Khalid Moore, the more points he's going to score. If they start doubling him, that'll open up more opportunities for Quisenberry. But, I mean, he's the team leader in assist. So, if he keeps moving the ball, that's good for the team. And if he really, get out of the shooting slump, you're going to need other guys to step up and give him more opportunities of better shots.
Antrell Charlton has also had a rather quiet day. 1 of 5 from the field, 2 points for him. Does have an assist. No rebounds, which is strange for Charlton. As we mentioned, Fordham getting outperformed on the glass. That can't continue to happen. You need people like Quisenberry to step up, but you need that rebound number to go up as well. Looking at what George Washington brings to the table, it's very clear they're a shooting team. Shooting teams, as you know, Owen, NBA, in college, very hard to slow down when they have it going right. On the game, George Washington shooting 51.7% from the field, Fordham shooting 39.4%. They're lucky to be trailing by 4 points right now, Omley.
Yeah, no. Especially like when you're playing a really good shooting team, you could even be playing good defense, but you just got to hope they start missing. So for the second half, Fordham's just going to have to continue playing strong defense and just hope that some of the GW shots that were falling in the first half don't stop falling.
The things you like to see, though, George Washington has not exactly blown anyone out of the water with their three-point shooting today. You've mentioned this, Owen, 3 of 12 from downtown Fordham, only 2 of 10. Someone that we know can get it cooking from three-point range, Will Richardson, did it against LaSalle, has done it in the past. No points for him yet today, 0 of 3 from the field. He's someone I'm looking at right now as a freshman. Very unbothered type of freshman when you see him play, kind of relaxed. Can amp up the intensity from time to time, but for the most part, cool customer for sure. When he has that three-point ball going, this Fordham team gets a different element. Thomas mentioned it on the broadcast. He can work off the dribble. That's something you might look to as this game starts to wind down. You have home court advantage. The kid's going to be unbothered. Sometimes it's not a bad thing to be wet behind the ears. Everyone raves about the value of experience, but there's something to be said about unbridled enthusiasm, even when you're not supposed to have that much enthusiasm or confidence. You're just able to go in there and get the job done.
Especially today in a packed gym as like a freshman, that could just really get him going. I mean, he still hasn't taken a three yet in this game, but if he gets going, that could be really good, especially when you're young and don't have that experience. Getting the crowd behind you could really get him on a good hot streak going.
And it might be reminiscent of high school. High school gyms are packed because schools care about their friends playing in the game, things of that sort. Maybe a sense of familiarity could come to Will Richardson in this second half. I know I saw it myself at LaSalle. That gym was packed. It was intense, and something told me maybe he was more comfortable because it reminded him of a high school gym, that packed kind of environment to the gills, not really pretty around the edges. Fordham, much nicer gym than LaSalle, had to get that one in there. But if that's the environment we're dealing with, perhaps Will Richardson could give them a boost from behind the arc, help them push past George Washington.
Especially if this team, if Fordham hits a few threes in the second half, this game could change very fast, because GW's not shooting threes well either. And as if they just keep shooting threes well, this game, the Fordham will get the win.
Looking at this second half, Owen, is that what this boils down to? I find myself wondering if it does boil down to the three ball, given they're trailing by 4 points. George Washington has had an excellent day shooting the basketball, period, but has not been particularly great from behind the arc. We've been kind of talking about this. Does it boil down to Fordham's ability to make the three? Because the Colonials, they've demonstrated they don't really need the three to win games. They're not going to need the three to win this game per se. They're just going to need to keep hitting shots and making stops when necessary. If you're the Rams, do you then take it upon yourselves to say, no, we're going to make this a three-point game? Because while it's kind of been a George Washington shooting day, it could be our three-point day that ultimately pushes us past.
Yeah, I think it's definitely going to be for Fordham. They're going to have to keep shooting the three, and that's going to be their key to success. I also think defensively, trying to keep GW out of the paint and behind the arc is going to be very important for them. Because if they can just keep them shooting threes, I mean, they're shooting 25% from three, and then Fordham hits a couple of threes, this game could change very fast.
I'll agree with you for sure. We need a good game out of Will Richardson. Fordham needs a good game out of Kyle Rose. Khalid Moore needs to keep being Khalid Moore. Darius Quisenberry, it'd be nice if he could be more efficient for those Fordham Rams as well. Looking at this second half, going to be a fun one from the historic Rose Hill Gym. Once again, your Fordham Rams trail the George Washington Colonials by a mark of 37-33. Let's get you back out to the Rose Hill Gym. Sam Davis and Thomas Aiello have got the call for you.
Hey everybody, Sam Davis here. Check out WFUV Sports on Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at WFUV Sports, and Instagram at WFUV_sports. There you can find all of our content from our beat reporters covering all the New York professional sports, as well as clips and full shows from One-on-One, New York's longest-running sports call-in show. For everything WFUV Sports, follow us on our socials.
It's 90.7 WFUV New York. Listener-supported public media from Fordham, the Jesuit University of New York. On air, online, and always commercial-free.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Gym for second half action between the Fordham Rams and the George Washington Colonials. 37-33 our score. GW up out in front of Fordham. They controlled the pace throughout the first half. We're leading for most of it, but Fordham with a couple of runs to get now within 4 points here at halftime. And diving into some of the stats here from the first half of action, GW shooting 51% from the field in that first half versus Fordham shooting under 40%, just 39%. But something that Fordham did really well, especially defensively, they forced a lot of turnovers. We saw it at the very end of the first half, leading to the big dunk from Moore. 8 turnovers in the first half for George Washington. That's what Fordham does defensively. They really swarm and they create opportunities for them to work in transition. That's what they're going to need to keep doing here in this second half.
Well, anytime you can end the first half on a 5-0 run and its exclamation point is a Khalid Moore slam in transition, I think you're in a good spot. With Fordham, you're down 4, right? But some of the things we have to point out, the first one is the shooting efficiency, particularly from Darius Quisenberry, 4 of 11 from the field. Not that that's the worst he's shot in the first half this season, but some of the shots he's taking are very annoying. A pull-up mid-range is fine, but if a guy's on your back and he's reaching that hand over, it's sort of like shielding your eyes a little bit, right? But the other thing I really like about Darius Quisenberry is the fact that he can affect other areas of the game. He's got 4 assists right now, leads all players with assists. Meanwhile, for George Washington, it's been the James Bishop and Brendan Adams show, those two combining for 20 of the 37 George Washington points. But what really strikes me here, Sam, is the 3-point shooting from both teams, 25% for GW, 20% from Fordham. This is one of the better offensive teams George Washington is in the Atlantic 10, and they're only shooting 25% from 3. They're 3 of 12 from that distance. But really where you're going to win this game if you're Fordham is the free throw battle, right? They're 5 of 6 from the line, and I talked about it. They get to the line the third most in the Atlantic 10. They shoot at the third highest clip. Put all the pressure on the official to make a call when you're driving in the basket. Put all the pressure on them to make a call, whether it be on the ground or you can get someone in the air with the pump fake. And for Fordham as well, to get James Bishop to just throw him off of his rhythm, right, or Brendan Adams, bring almost like the Jordan rules. Bring all the pressure from the opposite side and force Bishop into a drive that pushes him outside of the paint. Send him to the corner. Bring a trap there, perhaps. Give your guys enough time to recover, and if he starts maybe falling off balance or he can't wiggle free, he'll throw the ball or he'll just lose it, and you've got a turnover. And for George Washington, I know this is long right now, Sam, but for GW, you just got to keep running. Yeah. Move that ball. They've been really good at that today. 6 assists to Fordham's 8, but the ball flies around the perimeter. And James Bishop, that opens up driving lanes for him. Adams, Maximus Edwards really should be getting involved here in the second half. So if you can do those few things for both teams, either one has a good chance to win the game.
Fordham tasked with the very difficult task of slowing down a guy like James Bishop, especially when not only do you have to worry about James Bishop, but you also have to worry about Brendan Adams, especially if you put too much attention on James Bishop. Meanwhile, another surprising characteristic and stat here from the first half is the rebounding battle in favor of George Washington, 21-14. That's something that's been an interesting trend here in the first half, where you thought Fordham had the advantage in the boards, but it turns out GW's actually had that advantage.
Well, Fordham's actually the fifth highest rebounding team in the Atlantic 10, 37.2 per game. George Washington more towards that middle to the bottom area, but it's a real anomaly here at the Rose Hill Gym that Fordham is not winning the rebounding battle, but yet they're right in this game, right? It's almost as if they had to rebound the basketball to win the games. But I think today there's an exception that can be made, because you have to keep pace with George Washington. They're just so fast up and down the floor, and playing Khalid Moore or Elijah Gray at the 5, that's certainly not out of the question for Keith Urgell. And it's definitely something you want to think about going into the second half.
Second half action ready to get underway. Antrell Charlton will inbound on the near sideline. Fordham now moving left to right to get things started in half number 2. Lobs it to Nowitzki at the right arc. Here's Nowitzki passing it into the far corner. Moore tries a 3 real quick, and he hits it. Khalid Moore picking up where he left off, and a 1-point deficit now for the Rams. 37-36 in the first minute of play in the second half.
Well, what did I say? Fordham has to get off to a good start, right? You got to shoot the ball better.
Khalid Moore answered right there. Here's Bishop at the right arc. He's going to drive all the way into the paint. Good defense from Nowitzki. He misses the layup. Moore comes down with the board, passing it up ahead. Here's Quisenberry into the paint. Has his shot blocked. Nowitzki gets the miss. Moore goes in, has it knocked away. Here's 3-on-1 for GW. Up ahead, Bishop, and an easy 2 points for the Colonials. 39-36 in transition. They're up three. Here's Richardson advancing it over the timeline at the Fordham logo. Lobs it to Nowitzki at the right arc. Passing it to the left arc. It's Quisenberry. Quisenberry holding it at his hip there. Off the screen, into the paint. Puts up the runner. Off the side rim. No good. Rebounded there by Edwards. 39-36. Quisenberry really can't get anything to fall here. As Edwards has it at the right arc. Passing it to Adams at the Fordham Rams logo. Now he looks to drive all the way into the paint. Puts up the short jump shot off the back of the rim, but gets his own miss. And he's going to be fouled after the offensive rebound. Brennan Adams is sent to the deck there. It's a foul on the floor, which means GW will inbound underneath their own basket, leading by three, 39-36.
Fordham not rebounding the basketball at all now to open up the second half. That one should have been in their possession.
Lobbing it into Lindo. He has it at the A-10 logo there in the paint, and a foul is called. The fans don't like that call from the referees. Immediately as the ball was inbounded against the Rams. It's going to be against Khalid Moore. Just his first foul. He's leading the way with 16 points, leading all scorers in this one. 5-for-7 from the field and 4-for-4 from the line. Adams looks to find somebody to pass it into, finds Dean, and now gets it right back in the near corner. Here's Adams. Guarded by Charlton. Spins in the paint, has it the left block. Fadeaway jump shot, too short, but the tip back by Lindo is good. 41-36, GW in front. Ricky Lindo, a very talented rebounder, leads the team in rebounding, has had a lot of success against Fordham in the past, had a double-double against them last year, 14 rebounds the year before against the Rams, transfer from Maryland, bounce pass to Nowitzki at the top of the circle, now he splits the lane, bounce pass to Moore here in the near corner, right back to Nowitzki, entry pass at the left block, he goes up with it, misses, rebounded by Lindo, Lindo able to pull that one down. Here's Bishop the other way, going coast to coast underneath the basket. Now has it in the near corner, and will slow things down a little bit, bring it outside the three-point line. Through the legs dribble, passing it to Dean. Here's Dean, handing it off to Adams. Finding Dean on the pick and roll, he puts it up, misses the floater. Lindo flying in for the rebound. Here's Adams with the left arc, open three, too short. Richardson grabs that one, trying to find it up ahead to Quisenberry, but a bad pass, a turnover. Lindo falls to the deck, but is able to hold on to it, passing it to Adams, going coast to coast. Adams misses the layup. Charlton grabs the rebound. Crazy couple of minutes there, 41-36. Fordham trailing by five, 17 minutes to go in the second half. Here's Quisenberry in the far corner. He drives into the paint. Bounce pass to Richardson now in the near corner. Richardson moving in the baseline. Darts ahead, puts it up, and one. Count the basket for Will Richardson. 41-38. Fordham trailing by three. Richardson will be at the line. He's finally on the board in the stat sheet.
Well, that's the Will Richardson we've been accustomed to the last few games. Get into the paint, draw a foul, and go to the free throw line. He's got to get going here in the second half.
Richardson had 16 points last game against St. Bonaventure, and averaging 13.5 points per game in his last four. Has been red hot for the Rams, like you mentioned, Thomas, but his first points of the game here, definitely something that can help Fordham going forward if he can start to get hot, get that confidence rolling. The free throw is too short, so he misses in the and-one opportunity. It's just a two-point basket, so it's still a three-point deficit. 41-38, GW up with 16:45 remaining in the second half. Here's Bishop off a high screen from Dean. Spins inside the paint, bounce pass, a great find to Edwards, and one. You count that basket as well. Edwards, with a two-handed flush, will head to the line for one more. It's 43-38, GW now up five.
That was a great backdoor cut by Maximus Edwards on the baseline. Ball handler waited for him, and he has a chance for one more at the line and a free dunk as well.
Edwards at the foul line for GW. Maximus Edwards, a freshman, but certainly doesn't play like one, has been averaging over 10 points a game this year for GW as the student section tries to make some noise, but he hits the free throw anyway. So the old-fashioned three-point play for the Colonials. 44-38, they lead by six. 16-30 remaining here in half number two. Charlton dribbles with the right hand, now picks it up, bounce pass to Nowitzki. Nowitzki pivots, looks to drive in the paint, spins, now kicks it out. Charlton, right arc three, and he hits it. Antrell Charlton from deep. It's 44-41. Fordham back within three.
Fordham gets another three-pointer. Antrell Charlton hasn't been shooting the ball particularly well this year. Only 27% coming into today, but he hits a huge one.
Bishop driving into the lane. Wild pass out to Harris. Now Dean puts up the floater, rattles in and out, rebounded by Nowitzki. Here's Charlton the other way. The Rams are pushing in transition. Charlton off a high screen, crossover, 15-footer, too short, rebounded by Edwards. Bishop lobbing it up ahead into the paint at the right block. Lindo puts it up. That one rolls around the basket and goes in. 46-41, GW up five, 15-30 remaining in the second half. Here's Charlton advancing it over the timeline for the Rams. Charlton bounce pass to Nowitzki. Has it at the extended right elbow. Nowitzki going to work on Dean. One-on-one in the paint. Nowitzki lowering his shoulder. Pump fake, puts it up, and he's fouled. Nowitzki drawing some contact and will head to the free throw line after our first break here in the second half. 15-14 remaining in half number two. 46-41, GW out in front of Fordham. You're listening to the Fordham Rams basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hey everyone, I'm Will Grant.
And I'm Chris Persiainen.
And we're two of the hosts for WFUV's very own basketball podcast, Pick and Pod.
Tune in weekly for updates and our takes on the latest around the NBA, as well as exclusive insight from our very own Knicks and Nets beat reporters.
We'll have you covered on everything from all of the NBA's latest drama we know and love,
to debating all year long which team will get to lift that golden Larry O'Brien in June.
So don't miss a beat from the hardwood on WFUV's Pick and Pod.
Back and forth action to begin half number two at the Rose Hill Gym. It's 46-41. George Washington out in front by five with 15-14 remaining in the second half. We've seen Will Richardson get on the board. We've seen Fordham feeding the paint once again, trying to find success with Rostik Nowitzki under the basket, who outside of the first couple of possessions of the game has been pretty quiet throughout today. Abdu Simbila has played a limited number of minutes. He's been kind of dealing with a knee injury. He's been dealing with some issues there. He was a limited practice participant this week, but Fordham really needs Rostik Nowitzki to step up, especially with that paint presence, if they want to work their way back into this one.
We talked about going inside and drawing fouls because Fordham's one of the best teams that does that.
Yep.
Rostik Nowitzki went right into the paint, took his time with the back down, waited for Hunter Dean to reach, and he gets two free throws out of it. That's how Fordham's going to win this game. You have to find a way to slow down the Colonials. They love to run. They're 100th in the nation in pace, according to KenPom. Adjusted tempo, right? You got to slow them down somehow. That's one of the ways you can do that. Also, having to climb back into this rebounding battle. It's 29-18. George Washington is up. But you somehow have to try and get close to that. Keep it in the 29-25 range, really giving yourself a good shot as we get to crunch time.
You mentioned that rebounding battle. Ricky Lindo has really dominated that rebounding battle on his own. He has 10 rebounds already in this game, still 15 minutes remaining in it. He's also got 9 points, so flirting with a double-double. A guy who had 6 double-doubles last year has had just one this season. The leading rebounder for GW has been active on the boards all day long. And part of that is Fordham missing Abdu Simbila, who's sat on the bench for the majority of today. Simbila's played just 5 minutes. And it's Rostik Nowitzki who's at the line, shooting two shots. The first one is up. It's off the front rim, but a nice forgiving bounce, and it falls. Nowitzki will have one more from the charity stripe, 46-42. The Rams trailing by four now. Nowitzki puts the ball on the deck, and the second free throw is good as well. So two big shots there for the Rams. It'll be Elijah Gray, the freshman, checking in for Nowitzki now. 46-43, Fordham trailing by three. George Washington with the ball, moving right to left. It's Brennan Adams working it across the logo. Guarded by Quisenberry at the right arc. Passing it to Lindo. Thought about a three, but pass it ahead instead to Dean. Here's Dean at the right block. Spins, guarded by Charlton. Puts up the floater. No good. Tipped up. Moore grabs the board. 46-43. Good defense from Charlton there in the paint. Here's Moore. Driving into the lane. Spins, puts it up, and it's fouled. To lead Moore. 16 points. 4-for-4 from the line, and he's returning to the charity stripe for the Rams, who trail by three.
Well, Hunter Dean should have won that mismatch on the offensive end against Antrell Charlton. He has about 4 or 5 inches of height on the guy, and he just throws up this short hook shot that really almost was lucky to graze the rim. And on the other end, defensively, Fordham goes right at him, and Khalid Moore is getting more free throws.
Moore now with 17 points as he hits the first one. 46-44. The second shot from Moore is off the side of the rim. He misses it. Rebounded there by Dean. So one of two from the line, 46-44. Rams trailing by two. They haven't led since it was 2-0 in the first minute and a half of the game. GW has controlled the lead, although it's been a lot closer here in the second half and at the end of the first half, as Harris has it at the far wing. He drives, spins, puts it up, misses it. Rebounded by Gray. Fordham with a chance to tie or take the lead. Here's Gray. He goes coast to coast, puts his shoulder down. The layup's good. Elijah Gray flexes as the Rams tie it up at 46 apiece. 14 minutes remaining in the second half.
Look at Coach Ergo trying to get the crowd involved, throwing his hands up.
Firing up this crowd at the Rose Hill Gym. A sold-out Rose Hill Gym. We're tied at 46. Here's Bishop in the paint. Stops, puts up the jumper, and silences that crowd as he puts a finger to his mouth, telling everybody to be quiet. James Bishop with an impressive mid-range jumper there. He's now up to 15 points. And GW regains the lead, and then immediately a careless mistake there from the Rams. They turn it over. Bishop in transition, passing it to Lindo. Now Bishop at the right wing. GW will slow it down a little, 48-46. Lindo passing into the paint. Here's Dean. He goes up, gets rejected by the rim, but gets his own miss and gets the layup in. The Rams brought the double team to Bishop. It freed up Dean in the paint there, but he got rejected by the rim about as hard as you can, but got his own miss and gets the layup. It's 2 points regardless for GW. Gray, step back three, too short. Bad shot there from the freshman. 50-46, GW up four. Adams in transition, right arc, misses the three, rebounded by Quisenberry. DQ pushing it in transition, coast to coast, with the right hand off the glass, and he's fouled. Gray tried to put back the miss, but DQ went to the ground hard. He's holding his hands over his head here, but is now being helped up by Charlton and Rose. Looks like Quisenberry will be okay, and that's a good sign for the Rams, as DQ will head to the line, 50-46, GW up four.
Well, that was a wild sequence of events.
Got to catch your breath there. Crazy couple of minutes. Jeez.
Hunter Dean just throws the ball in the front of the rim, and the rim says, get that out of here, but he somehow gets an offensive rebound. Then Elijah Gray not paying attention, not understanding situation, time and score, just let the ball get right past him and a free score. But now Fordham's got a chance to put 2 points back on the board.
Fordham was able to tie the game, but then GW and James Bishop came right down the court and quieted this crowd immediately with a basket. And then referee talking to Quisenberry here is at the charity stripe, waiting for his free throws. It's 50-46. Rams trailing by four. DQ, a very talented free throw shooter, 85.9% on the season. First free throw's up and good. And it's the first free throws of the day for Darius Quisenberry. So Rams are within three, 50-47.
Just talk about how I said earlier Elijah Gray is not ready to be a point center. Just ran up the floor in transition on the previous sequence and threw up a really tough layup.
Really impressive from Gray there. But then on the other end, the ill-advised shot, and that's what you get with a freshman. You get some really high leverage and high octane moments there, and then on the other end, you get a mistake as Coach Ergo talks to the freshman Gray as he takes a seat. DQ hit both free throws, so it's 50-48. They trail by two. Here's Adams at the right arc, looking to pass it away, and he's fouled. Fans don't like that call. He was in the air trying to pass it away. And it's going to be a foul called on the floor, which means GW will inbound underneath their own basket, leading by two, 50-48. 12:43 remaining in the second half. Overhead pass to Bishop, who has it at the right wing. Bishop drives into the paint. Double team, puts it up, blocked by Nowitzki. He gets the rebound as well. Here's Charlton the other way. The Rams looking to push a little. Now they'll slow it down. Quisenberry at the right arc. He has it at his hip. High screen from Moore. Comes off of it. Quisenberry passing it to Charlton. Here's Rose. Straight on. Thought about a three. Passes it up. Bounce pass into the paint. Here's Nowitzki working on Brown. He spins. Nowitzki passing it to a cutting Quisenberry off the glass. The finger roll's good. We're back tied at 50. 12 minutes remaining in the second half.
Great cut by Quisenberry. Good situational awareness. Saw Rostik Nowitzki was stuck in the mud, but bails him out. Now we're tied at 50.
This crowd is getting loud once again. Tied at 50, under 12 minutes to play. Brown handing it off and a foul. Whistles fly here as Adams is drawing another foul there. 50-50 our score. Under 12 minutes to play at 11:50. And a timeout here on the floor, which means we're going to send it back to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one scoreboard with Owen Kelty.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Starting off in the A-10, LaSalle leads Rhode Island 50-37. Later today, Richmond heads to Dayton, Duquesne plays UMass, and St. Bonaventure goes to VCU. For top 25 play, number 7, Virginia routes Boston College 76-57. West Virginia upsets number 15, Auburn, 80-77, and Creighton upsets number 13, Xavier, 84-67. For the later slate of top 25 play, number 2, Alabama trails Oklahoma 50-33 at half, Missouri leads number 12, Iowa State, 42-32 at half, and Cincinnati leads number 3, ranked Houston, 43-36 at half. Capping off a big day for top 25 basketball is a huge rivalry game between number 9, Kansas, and unranked Kentucky at 8 p.m. Over in the association, we have another big rivalry game between the Knicks and the Nets in Brooklyn at 5:30 p.m. And at 8:30, the Lakers will ship up to Boston as LeBron James chases the NBA scoring record. With the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Owen Kelty.
Welcome back to a loud Rose Hill gym here. Exciting A-10 basketball between Fordham and George Washington. Knotted up at 50 apiece with 11:50 remaining in the second half. Fordham in the first half trailed for most of it, but was within single digits for most of that first half. Ended up trailing at halftime by about 5 points and still have not led since it was 2-0 all the way back in the first minute of action, but have been tied twice and have an opportunity here to go out and take the lead and ride the momentum from the crowd here at the Rose Hill Gym.
Well, Fordham is really getting their scoring from a number of different places. Khalid Moore, Elijah Gray have been doing a lot of the damage. Rostik Nowitzki going to the free throw line a couple times, and now Darius Quisenberry bailing out Nowitzki, caught in the mud, back or cuts down the middle, gets a free layup rather, and now they're tied up at 50. But it seems like every time Fordham gets momentum, they do something that's a little puzzling or mind-boggling, right? They come down. Keith Ergo's taking a page out of Ed Cooley's book, hyping up the crowd, acting like the student section leader. Then they go down on the defensive end and just commit a foul, which you don't want to do that when you have the momentum going your way. And this George Washington team, they're also really good at capitalizing on mistakes. You have to prevent runs from them. That's been the key. You got to try and hold them from going on these 6 or 7 point runs. If you can stop that, you've got a good chance to win.
Both times Fordham has tied the game, we've seen a couple of those mistakes like you talked about, Thomas, which kind of takes a little bit of the energy out of this place, which is hard to do because there's definitely a lot of it. But Fordham is trying to ride that momentum here in the remaining just under 12 minutes. As it's going to be Amir Harris inbounding on the near sideline. He will look to pass it in. Adams off a couple of screens. Now will drive baseline. Handing it to Brown. Brown at the extended right elbow. Underneath the block, it's Harris. He goes up and he's fouled. Looked like a lot of ball there.
Yeah, I don't know about
on
that
defense.
One.
But the foul is the call, which will send Amir Harris to the line for two shots.
I don't know. Some of these calls in the NCAA now with the calls under the basket, it looks like a block, but the referees call a slap on the arm. They really are extremely close, but really can go either way. The officials decided that was a foul.
Harris nails the first free throw. We'll have one more. Played in a season-high 21 minutes last game against St. Joe's. Appears mostly off the bench, but is getting more minutes lately for George Washington, a team with a short bench. Plays their starters a lot of minutes. As the second free throw is also hit. So GW with a two-point lead, 52-50. 11:42 remaining in the second half. Moore passing it in to Richardson. He's going to go the length of the court. Will Richardson over the midcourt line. Passing it to Charlton at the left arc. Lobs it into the paint. A good pass to Nowitzki at the right block. Nowitzki one-on-one with Brown. Spins. Nowitzki now double team. Puts it up and he's fouled. Nowitzki drawing some contact. Will be back at the charity stripe for two more and a chance to tie this game up once again.
We see what Fordham's trying to do offensively. Obviously, it's feed the post, because that's what's really been working for them so far. But the second cutter, Khalid Moore diving through the middle again, just in case Nowitzki or the big posting up gets caught in a trap or a double team. They have a bailout option. You just have to see it before it comes. And you can't exactly telegraph it with your eyes. You just have to anticipate and know that it's coming. But for Fordham right now, Nowitzki pounding the paint has been good for them.
Nowitzki, a 65% free throw shooter. The first shot is good. He's 4-5 from the line here today, with 9 points. And make that 10 points as the second shot also falls. We're back tied at 52, 11:26 remaining in the second half. Nowitzki will sub out. Gray, the freshman, back in. Getting a lot of minutes here, a lot of important minutes for the Rams. Coach Ergo showing his trust in these freshmen, especially Gray, as Lindo has it. And now, here's Adams advancing it over half court. Adams, the near sideline, guarded by Richardson. Crossover move, now at the left arc. Here's Adams, dribbling with the left hand, passing it out to Bishop at the Fordham logo. Here's Bishop, holding it at his hip. Bishop, he's double teamed by Rose and Charlton, forcing a steal, but it falls into the hands of Dean. Dean in the paint. Two in the shot clock, one. A beautiful move in the post for Dean. And an easy finger roll puts GW back up 54-52.
Oh, the head fake. Elijah Gray just shakes free. You got to stay on your feet. That's just an upperclassman showing a freshman how it's done.
GW getting a fortunate bounce there as they brought the double team on Bishop. Here's Moore in the paint. At the right block, puts it up, has it blocked. Gets his own miss, though, and a jump ball as Dean falls to the ground. Possession arrow in favor of George Washington, which means the Colonials will have possession, leading by two with 10:34 remaining in the second half. It's going to be Bishop looking to go length of the court here, inbounding. Passes it into Adams. Brandon Adams will work it up. He's got 9 points in this one, just 3 of 12 from the floor after 32 points last game against St. Joe's. Off a high screen from Dean. Adams lobs it to Dean at the top of the key. Dean looks to hand it off to Edwards, but instead, still looking to pass it around. And a foul is called off the ball there. Looks like it's going to go against Richardson, guarding Brendan Adams. A lot of ticky-tack calls here in the last couple of minutes, and with that, GW into the bonus. So 1-1, which is something definitely to note here, with 10:16 remaining in the game. GW will have at least one free throw from here on out, and shortly they'll be in the double bonus at this pace, as it's Adams at the line for a 1-1. First shot is up. It's good.
For Fordham, you want to try and stay disciplined on defense. Again, the crowd is a factor. Can sort of lead to erratic and undisciplined play. You need to try and control yourself, get back in a good headspace, go to what coach has been telling you to do, and just execute it correctly.
Adams waiting for the ball for his second shot at the line. Spins it, puts it up. That one's too short, rebounded by Moore. So a 1-1 at the line there with GW into the bonus. 55-52, they lead by three. Under 10 minutes to play in the second half. Richardson off a screen, straight away, three. It's good. Will Richardson with a big time basket. back tied at 55, under 10 minutes to play. Adams over the half court line, guarded by Richardson, and a foul again called against Richardson. Coach Ergo not happy with his freshman there, as he just stuck his hand out just a little too much in the defense, and Adams will have another 1-1 at the line.
I was doing a little bit of lip reading from Coach Ergo. I can't repeat some of the words he said on the air, but you can just see some of the frustration. This is what you're going to get, like you said, with a freshman. They're going to do some really good things. Wilt hits a little three-pointer off of a high screen. That's his favorite shot. And he comes down defensively and just commits a really foolish foul. You just want to try and clean those up.
Miss there on the free throw. It's in and out, out of bounds, knocked away, and Fordham will have it. So taking advantage of the missed free throw. We're still tied at 55. The student section right behind the basket where George Washington is shooting here in the second half, making some noise. 9:30 remaining in the second half. Richardson stops and starts, passes it. Moore, right arc three. Yes! Colleen Moore! Fordham grabs the lead, 58-55. Rose gets a steal. He puts up a three. Too strong. Rebounded by Edwards.
Would have needed earplugs if that three went in. The roof was going to blow off this place.
That would have blown the roof off of this place. Already high energy here. Bishop at the right arc. Double teamed. Passes it ahead. And a travel. A traveling violation. Fordham forces it. 58-55, they're up three, 9-11 remaining in the second half.
Good morning, Rose Hill. Jim, where have you been all afternoon? This is the loudest the gym has ever been in a long time. And George Washington, they need a timeout.
George Washington gonna talk things over with 9 minutes and 11 seconds remaining here in the second half. We need a minute to take a breath. 58-55, Fordham over George Washington. And Thomas, in the last couple of minutes, Khalid Moore now up to 20 points. A huge three-pointer from Will Richardson. Fordham really using that momentum, turning the screws, grabbing their first lead since the first couple of minutes of the game.
Well, Khalid Moore has been Superman today. 20 points, 5 of 6 from the line. How about this one, ready? 3 of 4 from long distance. Khalid Moore is a 31% three-point shooter. He's shooting 75% today. Georgia Tech, again, same thing we talked about. He's a role player, didn't shoot the ball too much. But my goodness, he's just really exploded here in Atlantic 10 play. But he's got some friends today. Rostik Nowitzki with 10 points, going to the free throw line 6 times. Quisenberry's got 12. Will Richardson hit a huge three. Kyle Rose trying to get in on the fun, but his shooting slump continues. Going down to the nitty-gritty, looking at the X factor. Let's start with Fordham, right? It has to be Kyle Rose. His defense is really good, but you got to hit 1-3. You just have to hit one.
Well, definitely a little bit of an ill-advised shot there, I will say. After the chaos of the Moore 3, Rose actually does a great job getting a steal, but then it's just 3-on-1. 3 George Washington defenders and only him. He decides to take that 3. Just not the best shot, especially with the momentum on your side.
Well, one of the things you want to do, especially when you're a fourth-year senior like Rose, you got to slow it down. You got to show these young guys, especially in a big moment like this, yes, the crowd is a factor, but the crowd is not Keith Ergo. The crowd's not Chris Caputo. You can't let them dictate how you're going to play. That's like me going out of this broadcast and going over into that huddle and telling them what to do just because I see it. No one's going to listen to you if you do that, but the point being, you have to play the way coach tells you to play, especially in college. There's more intangibles. Those are more of a factor in the college game. And for George Washington, for Chris Caputo, it wouldn't shock me if they come out of this timeout and they just run the simple set, get something under the basket. Defensively, they got to bring the energy up as well. I think it's been good today. It's been better than it's been for most part of the season, especially in the Rose Hill where it's loud. It's a small gym. The noise kind of carries over from the fans. They'll just seep over into the court, and I think that can get into your head a little bit. But for George Washington defensively, they're going to try and pick it up, and they've done a pretty good job of doing that today.
And another thing George Washington's going to try and do is keep getting to that free throw line. They're already in the bonus, 1-1. They'll be soon in the double bonus, shooting 2-3 free throws the rest of the way. Still a lot of time left in this one. That's something that could be important for them. And Fordham on the defensive side of the ball doing a really nice job. Once again, I mentioned it earlier, with the turnovers. They've forced 10 GW turnovers. They've only committed 6 themselves. That's been a big thing for Fordham winning that turnover battle, they've been able to do that so far here today.
And I think for Fordham, especially the out-of-conference, one of the problems we saw, I was staring them in the face, was the turnovers. A number anywhere between 10 and 15 was good for them in that out-of-conference schedule, but now they're really starting to clean it up.
A team that averages 14 turnovers a game, with just six so far in this one. Here's Richardson at the left arc, drives into the paint, splits the defense, loses it, and Dean comes up with it. Has the ball poked away, and then on the other end, knocks it out of bounds. Richardson trying to get a steal, jump in the passing lane, but it's deflected off of his hands, which means GW will keep it. 58-55, Fordham up three, under 9 minutes to play in the second half. If you're just joining us, GW had the lead for most of the first half. Fordham's grabbed it now in the second. Back and forth action here at the Rose Hill Gym. A double team coming to Bishop. Rose gets a steal. Here's Charlton the other way, passing it to Rose. Left arc triple, no good. Gray tries to tip up the offensive rebound. It's deflected out of bounds off of Fordham. Another three-pointer that, if it fell, would have sent this place into a frenzy. But instead, the Rams holding on to just their three-point lead.
Kyle Rose really doesn't think he's struggling shooting the basketball. He's just hoisting up those threes. He doesn't care if he's contested or open. Kudos to him for trying to work through the slump.
0 for 5 from the field, 0 for 3 from behind the arc with 0 points for Kyle Rose. As Adams has it at the top of the perimeter. Guarded by Richardson. Adams passing into the far corner, Lindo. He's going to try a triple, in and out. Rebounded by Richardson. Richardson across the logo for the Rams. Passing it to Charlton at the left wing. Charlton still has it. He's going to try a left arc three. That one's too strong. It's not really Fordham's game shooting these threes. They've missed back-to-back triples. They still lead by three. Bishop passing it into the near corner. Open is Lindo. He takes it, and he hits it. Ricky Lindo with a massive three-point shot. We're back tied at 58, under 8 minutes to play.
Fordham's defense is designed to let non-shooters shoot. Obviously, Ricky Lindo is not the best shooter in the world, shooting 24% from three. That time he hit one.
Moore drives baseline up and under is good. Khalid Moore gives the Rams the lead right back, 60-58. 7:30 remaining in the second half. Crossover move from Bishop. He has it at the right arc, passes it to Dean at the free throw line. Dean has it poked away by Charlton. It's another steal. Richardson the other way. Hesitates, now drives into the paint, dishes it off to Rose. Rose passing it back out to Richardson. Swing it to Charlton, left arc triple, and he hits it. Andrell Charlton from deep, 63-58. Fordham up five, 7:10 remaining in the second half.
How about that, making the extra pass if you're Will Richardson, that's a great play.
The crowd is on their feet once again. It's Bishop passing it in the far corner. Lindo, he's going to try another. That one's too short. Rebounded by Richardson. Richardson tossing it up ahead to Gray. One-on-one in the paint. He puts it up. And the foul! Elijah Gray has his crowd fired up. 65-58. 6:52 remaining in the second half. And a media timeout here. The Rose Hill Gym is rocking. The Rams lead by seven. You're listening to Fordham Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Hey folks, this is Thomas Aiello
with Ryan Gregware,
and we're your main hosts for WFUV Sports' new college basketball podcast, Storm the Court.
We'll talk about the top 25 rankings, some of the big games from the week before, and preview the slates ahead.
We also talk Fordham basketball, both men's and women's, so don't be afraid to listen to that as well.
Tyler Hu and Danny Scott also joined the show as recurring hosts.
So make sure to tune in to Storm the Court, a production of WFUV Sports. This is the road to March.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Gym. 65-58. Fordham up seven over George Washington. They've taken the lead here in the second half and have not looked back here as they look to extend it here in the final 6 minutes and 52 seconds. Still a lot of time left in this game, but Khalid Moore leading the way with 22 points, and Elijah Gray, the freshman, has really stepped up without Abdu Simbila getting a lot of minutes. He's had some really, really important baskets. He's got 6 points and five rebounds on the day.
Well, if you're going to talk about the freshman group, obviously Will Richardson has separated himself a little bit, but Elijah Gray has come on as of late. Last game, 7 points at St. Bonaventure. That's not the easiest place to play in the Atlantic 10, but how about him turning into a man-child under the basket, just pummeling right through defenders and going for a tough layup and an and-one, and a little 19-year-old freshman, and I say he's little, but he's 6'8", 220-something
pounds. A lot bigger
than
you are.
I mean, I'm only 5'10". Come on, man. But let's stick with the facts here. This kid, the coaching staff was raving about him preseason, signed on late, came on around the June, July area, just before the team went on their foreign trip, and he's really impressed. Stretch big, can get inside the paint. He's a tough kid. He also played at Hargrave Military Academy, and those kids, stone cold, no personality, some of them, but he's come to Fordham. He's brought a different level of toughness, and it's really starting to show and starting to catch pace with Will Richardson, separating himself from a typical freshman.
Gray, a guy that averages just 5 minutes per game heading into today, has 16 minutes in this one, which shows how much trust Coach Ergo has in him to get some big-time minutes and to really impact the game the way that he has.
I'll tell you what, if he adds 5 or 10 more pounds to his frame and he gets a little quicker, he's going to be a problem in the Atlantic 10.
Definitely some positive signs for the freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina. And he's at the line as the arena goes silent here for the shot. No good off the front of the rim. Rose is able to grab the offensive rebound after it's tipped around. Cross-court pass. Quisenberry near arc three. Yes! The threes are raining down here at the Rose Hill Gym. 68-58, Fordham up 10.
How much fun is this?
Here's Bishop the other way, looking to silence this crowd for GW, having 15 points, 7 of 14 from the floor, passing it out to Dean at the top of the perimeter. Dean driving on Charlton, puts it up, misses, too strong, but a foul is called. Antrell Charlton doing everything he can, the guard hanging around with the big guy, Hunter Dean, in the post. He's got a 5-inch size advantage over him, but Dean is able to pick up the foul and heads to the charity stripe for two shots.
Well, that was good help defense by Fordham. Elijah Gray leaves his man, rotates to the weak side. He was able to get a pretty decent contest. But Hunter Dean, again, much more experienced, much more built, played a lot more than him, knows what to do in those situations.
First free throw rattles out from Dean as the crowd loves it. The student section making some noise here. 68-58, the Rams up 10. With 6:22 remaining in the second half. Dean spins the basketball. Second shot is up and good. It's 68-59 now. Rose will inbound under his own basket, pass it to Moore, who passed it to Quisenberry, getting a massive 3-point shot to fall. He's now 1-for-4 from behind the arc, 15 points on the day. Quisenberry now has it at the left arc. High screen from Nowitzki. He comes off it. Floater in the lane, and it rolls in. A nice basket for Darius Quisenberry, 70-59. Fordham up 11. And an offensive foul the other end as Bishop stuck his elbow into Kyle Rose, who was able to set his feet, get the charge. Fordham will have possession back.
What a sequence of events for Fordham. Darius Quisenberry with 5 points of his own in the span of a couple of minutes. A nice floater, a huge three. And now a great defensive play by Kyle Rose. He's really making a case for A-10 all defense.
Rose inbounding on the far sideline, passes it into Charlton, who's going to say to his offense, slow things down a little bit. Bounce pass to Quisenberry at the left arc. Finds Nowitzki, hands it right back to Quisenberry. Quisenberry at the top of the key. He's double-teamed. Trying to dribble out of it, passes to Charlton, who swings it. Cross court, here's Moore. Pump fakes, drives into the paint, goes up, and is fouled. Foul on the floor going against Khalid Moore. He's able to draw some contact, leading all scorers with 22 points on the day. He's also got 6 rebounds.
You also have to say, Sam, that Khalid Moore, the things he can do, he's so long and lengthy, and it's almost like he just slips through things. He just can slip through a crack of a double team, have no problem doing it.
First free throw rattles around and drops. And 1-1 now as Fordham's into the bonus also. GW still in the bonus. It's now 71-59, by far the largest lead of the game for the Rams. Before about midway through the second half, they only led once in this game, and that was in the first couple of minutes. But they've been able to grab the lead in the second half and are now extending it. going up 72-59. 5:30 remaining. Here's Adams at the top of the perimeter. Draws the double team, passes it out to Dean at the right elbow. Here's Dean. Pivots, passing into the near corner. Lindo tries another, in and out. Rebounded by Moore. Quisenberry will slow it down as now time is in favor of the Rams as they're up 72-59, 13-point lead here. Bounce pass to Moore at the extended left elbow, holds it over his head. Jab step, mid-range jumper, in and out. Rebounded by Adams for GW. He just loses it out of bounds, trying to get over half court. That's been a summary of the day for George Washington. Another unforced error, a turnover. That's their 14th of the day. Fordham will take it as they'll have possession.
Well, that's the last person I thought would make a mistake like that. Brendan Adams is a graduate student. You would think he would slow the pace down, but he's trying to run in a game like this where you're down quite a few points.
72-59, under 5 minutes to play now in the second half. Bounce pass to Nowitzki at the right elbow, kicks it out, swinging it. Quisenberry thought about a three, lost it, drives in the paint, finger roll off the back rim. Nowitzki tried to tip it up, offensive rebound. Moore swinging it out to Quisenberry, has his pass blocked away. Pushing in transition is GW. Hop step from Edwards, an impressive move to the basket for Edwards, the freshman. Silences this crowd momentarily, gets the basket to go. It's an 11-point deficit for GW. Quisenberry at the right arc, passing into the near corner. Rose for three, in and out. Just rattles out for Kyle Rose. Sign of his struggles. Edwards trying to go coast to coast, loses possession of the ball. Here's Charlton the other way. Passing in Quisenberry, right arc, triple, air ball.
Oh boy.
Nowitzki tries to chase it down, throws it right into the hands of Adams. Both teams out and running, under 4 minutes to play. Finally a foul and a stoppage. Coach Ergo trying to tell his team, be smart, slow things down. Time is on their side. With 3:58 remaining, it's 72-61. Fordham out in front of George Washington. Let's go back to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one scoreboard with Owen Kelty.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Starting off in the A-10, LaSalle leads Rhode Island 50-37. Later today, Richmond heads to Dayton. Duquesne faces off versus UMass. And St. Bonaventure travels to VCU. For top 25 play, number 7 Virginia defeats Boston College 76-57. West Virginia takes down number 15 Auburn 80-77. And Creighton upsets number 13 Xavier 84-67. For the later slate of top 25 play, number 2 Alabama trails Oklahoma 70-53. Missouri leads number 12 Iowa State 64-46. And Cincinnati leads number 3 ranked Houston 49-42 early in the second half. Capping off the day for top 25 basketball is a big game between number 9 Kentucky and Kansas. Over in the NBA, the Knicks take on the Nets in Brooklyn. And at 8:30, LeBron will face off versus Jason Tatum as the Lakers play the Celtics.
Welcome back to the Rose Hill Gym. 3:58 remaining in the game. 72-61, Fordham out in front of George Washington, trailing for the majority of the first half, grabbing the lead in the second half, using the momentum from this crowd to now extend that lead. They find themselves up 11. And Thomas, my question to you, with just 4 minutes remaining, what does Fordham have to do to close this one out with a win?
Well, I think the first thing you have to do is play good defense, right? You have to sort of get George Washington off their rocker a little bit more than they already are, right? We saw earlier Keith Ergo taking a page out of Ed Cooley's book, hyping up the crowd. Now he's taking out a page from Shaheen Holloway's book, which is just play erratic, almost like undisciplined defense. Just you got to fly to the ball, get those hands out, be super active, communicate, talk really, really loud, move your feet really quickly. You got to be a disruptor. Offensively, we said it during the break to you, you got to slow down the tempo. You got to slow down the tempo, right? You don't want anyone or anything going out of bounds, flying 10 feet into the stands, taking an ill-advised step back three or something ridiculous to happen, right? You want to play at a pace that is aggressive, but again, it's still conservative and intelligent to the point where you can take a lot of clock off and hold a lot more of a possession than you would normally if this was the middle of the first half.
Something that Fordham's done really well in the second half of action is draw that double team to James Bishop, and he has not been able to pass out of it too many times. He's actually made some mistakes out of it, something that Coach Ergo talked about before the game, saying normally, you know, a very talented passer. He's got six assists tonight, but that double team has really caused some problems for George Washington.
He's got six turnovers, too.
Six turnovers, definitely a factor in this one, as Brennan Adams will hit both free throws. George Washington certainly not out of this game, however. Just a 9-point deficit now, 72-63. The largest lead was 13 points just about 30 seconds ago in terms of game clock. Now with 3:58 remaining in this one. Waiting for some subs here.
Oh, I think he didn't check into the scorer's table.
Window trying to get into the game. And looks like they're not going to let him in now until the next dead ball, as Rose will inbound under his own basket. GW opening up with some pressure here in the full court. Rose trying to find the open man. Pass it into Charlton. Charlton looking to go the length of the floor. GW brings the double team in the backcourt. Charlton's able to work his way over it. Passing it into the paint. Moore, he goes up. Gets the layup in. What a move from Khalid Moore. Hanging in the air. Off the glass for two. 24 points on the day. 74-63. Adams chucks up a three and he hits it. Right on the other end, a straightaway three for Brendan Adams, now with 12 points. He's been silent for a lot of the second half, but hitting a massive shot there for GW. As they bring a double team once again, but Fordham is able to easily make it past half court. 74-66, Fordham up by eight, 3:15 remaining in the second half. Bounce pass to Quisenberry at the left arc. Holds it at his hip, off a high screen. He's gonna try a three, and he drains it! Another three for Darius Quisenberry, 77-66. On the other way, they force a turnover. An ill-advised pass from Adams is intercepted by Khalid Moore. Fordham will slow it down, under 3 minutes to play, 77-66. Charlton is fouled there by Adams.
Forget anything I said about slowing down the tempo. George Washington just threw out a full-court press. You know what? Screw it. Why don't you just run the rest of the game? That's what George Washington wants you to do, but Fordham is also very good at running on the break. Now, again, not that they've been able to score as much as you would think they are, given they're one of the faster teams in the Atlantic 10, but they can play at any speed. As long as you get the ball across half court, you can slow it down and play any sort of style you want.
Darius Quisenberry, we talked about getting off to somewhat of a slow start, but has really picked it up here in the second half, now with 20 points, 8 for 19 from the field. He's taken plenty of shots in this one. Hit a big three for the Rams as Charlton at the line knocks down the free throw. A 78% shooter. We talked about Fordham's success at the line and how important it would be for them to get there today. This is their 20th shot at the charity stripe in this one.
It's also interesting too, Sam. We talked about Quisenberry sits down for a little bit, maybe mentally resets, and he's now 8 of 19 from the field. He's got 20 points.
79-66, Fordham up 13. That ball is poked away by Adams. Another steal for the Rams. Up ahead to Moore, and he throws it down. Khalid Moore, 81-66. The Rams are swarming all over the court. 2:37 remaining. This place is going nuts. Crowd is on their feet as Adams inbounds on the far sideline, passing it into Edwards. Edwards driving into the paint, jump stop, and he's fouled and will head to the line for two. Khalid Moore, explosive in transition. Another highlight reel dunk, 28 points now. He's leading all scores.
Well, this place is getting so loud, and the Rose Hill gym is so old, it's going to need a hearing aid after this game. I mean, this place is ready to go bonkers. They already are. A standing ovation from everyone in the gym.
Edwards at the line, gets the free throw to go. GW in the double bonus now, so they'll have two shots the rest of the way. 81-67, 14-point lead for Fordham.
How about this kid Edwards, so smooth, lefty. 10 points and 8 rebounds today.
First shot off the front of the rim, no good. He certainly hasn't been fazed by this environment, but the Rams swarming on defense. As GW tries to draw the double team, and it's going to be a 10-second violation. So George Washington forcing a turnover there. That's the only thing that's going to let this team back into the game if Fordham starts turning the basketball over like that.
We talked about the erratic tempo when you deploy a full-court press. Shaka Smart did it for a long time at VCU and had a lot of success with it. Other teams have done it as well, and Chris Caputo certainly embracing that style.
Here's Adams at the top of the key. Crossover move. The double team comes once again. Loses it for a moment, but gets it back. Fade away. Step back is good. What a shot from Brendan Adams. 81-69. He's now got 15 points. Make that 17, actually, leading the Colonials. Rose looks to pass it in. Finds Quisenberry. Passing it up ahead to Moore. Moore has it knocked away out of bounds, but possession will remain with Fordham. And they will for sure slow this one down with a minute 55. We're under 2 minutes to play in the game, 81-69. Time is in your favor. George Washington doing their best to try and force some more turnovers in the backcourt. A bounce pass into Quisenberry in the far corner. Quisenberry, guarded by Adams, drives baseline, goes up, off the glass and in. An easy layup for Darius Quisenberry. You'll take the points when you can get them. 83-69, 1:40 remaining in the game. Here's Bishop bringing it up for George Washington. High screen from Dean. Bishop draws the double team. Charlton gets another steal. Up ahead to Moore. It's showtime! The reverse slam! Khalid Moore! 85-69. A minute 15 remaining in the game. Bishop, a long three-pointer. It's off the back of the rim. Rebound snatched down by Nowitzki. And we're under a minute to play in the Bronx. 85-69. Fordham, what a game for the Rams. On their way to winning four straight in the Atlantic 10. We'll move to 5-3 with the win as they let some clock run out. Under 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Now down to five. Step back three from Quisenberry off the back of the rim. Grabbing the miss is Fordham. And they'll have another chance to waste some more time and let this crowd get loud. Under 30 minutes to play. And Charlton dribbling near the half court. 5 seconds on the shot clock. He will drive into the lane. And they'll just huck up a deep three. It's off the side rim. And the referees will blow this one dead. A shot clock violation. The shot clock is now off. 17.6 seconds remaining. And Thomas Fordham can soak up this W.
And you see the student section. Rather, you hear them cheering, "Hey, hey, goodbye," that song. Listen to this.
What an atmosphere from the Rose Hill gym today. All the subs will check in. The starters come out to a standing ovation here at the Rose Hill gym. The fans brought the energy. Fordham brought the energy in the second half. Trailed for almost the entire first half. Took the lead in the second. Never looked back. They lead 85-69 as George Washington and Adams into the paint. Goes up and he's fouled. And so he'll head to the line. We'll give the Rams a little bit longer to maybe enjoy this win here as it's 85-69. Brendan Adams, the leading scorer for George Washington with 17 points. Khalid Moore with 30 for the Rams. That's his career high.
Khalid Moore was Superman today. Darius Quisenberry gave him some nice help. 22 points, but how about some of these other Rams getting involved? Elijah Gray, we talked about, 6 points today. Nowitzki with 10. Will Richardson with 5. And Antrell Charlton, a quiet 10 points. 7 steals today. I didn't even notice that number until just now. 7 steals. Have to think about Fordham, this all defensive candidates. Charlton and Kyle Rowe certainly up there.
Will Richardson will let the clock run out here in this one. A massive victory for the Fordham Rams. It's 4 straight. They move to 17-4 and 5-3 in conference. 85-70 over George Washington here at the Rose Hill Gym. What a win for Fordham.
What an incredible game today going up against what was a really well-coached George Washington team, I thought, but Fordham's defensive scheme just threw them off, but no knock to George Washington at all. They're going to be a really good product for a very long time. Chris Caputo was a great hire for Foggy Bottom and everyone down in D.C., and boy, oh boy, do they have an identity shooting the basketball. They made it rain in the first half, and the second half, though, Fordham went on one of those monstrous runs. We're so accustomed to seeing Sam, and the fruits of their labor are paying off.
85-70 the final, a 15-point victory, a commanding victory for Fordham after trailing in the first half. And a huge win for the Rams, who really turned it on in half number two, as we're going to be joined by assistant coach Dave Paulson in a moment as he heads over with a smirk. And why not smile if you're Fordham for the game that they've had in this one? And coach, with us now, just talk about this win, what Fordham did so well in the second half to obviously take the lead and win this one at home.
Well, you know, I thought our defense, I don't know what the numbers were in the second half for them field goal wise, but I thought we really defended exceptionally high level. This is a really explosive offensive team that we just beat. And I thought Kyle Rose's energy on the defensive end, I don't know how what he scored, probably not a lot, okay, but just his defense, the Will Richardson defensively, Trell second half defensively, DQ, that's where it all started. That's where we have to be, grimy, nasty, competitive, hard-nosed on the defensive end. And we struggled shooting the ball in the first half, but our guys kept pounding away, and then really played, I thought, really well offensively in the second half across the board. You know, so just our toughness, our competitiveness, and hey, let's tip our hat to this crowd. I coached in this league for 6 years. I watched film of every one of their games. I never saw a crowd like this at Fordham
loud in here, coach.
Long time, and we need them back.
Coach, playing at such a fast and high tempo obviously can be really good, but sometimes the crowd maybe sort of eradicates that a little bit. It can sort of be an unhappy balance between playing disciplined and playing aggressive. How do you guys try to harness the two?
You're talking about some of those shots before the four-minute media timeout. You know, I think our guys, again, so the one thing about our guys that I love is they play with unbelievable emotion and passion. They have an unshakable confidence in themselves. I would rather have that and try to rein them in than the other, because you've seen that competitiveness, that toughness. We've worn teams down the last four games where we were trailing and wore them down. So, yeah, it needs to be harnessed a little bit. But to their credit, after a four-minute media timeout, we came down to execute, ran good offense, and, you know, played under control. So, you know, you can't have perfection, but I love how hard our guys compete.
Coach Khalid Moore with a massive 30 points in this one. What'd you see from him, and even Darius Quisenberry as well, right there with 22. What'd you see from the offense, especially those two guys?
Well, Khalid is just playing really, really, really well the last four games. I think since we lost to Dayton, you know, he's just been aggressive. He might miss a shot, but he's been in attack mode. He's getting on the glass, and he just really fuels us. You know, DQ has struggled shooting the ball from three lately, but he got two in the second half. But he learned how to, you know, go to the rim and attack, so he kept playing hard. You know, again, I thought Roslov gave us a great effort. I thought Elijah Gray was phenomenal. Of course, you know, Abdu has some knee pain and just really tried to give it a go.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't play down the stretch at St. Bonnie's. Tried to give it a go, just couldn't function. And so Elijah, you know, I think there's a career high in minutes, 3 for 4. You know, his plus minus, plus 14. You know, great job off the bench.
Coach, one more for me. Kyle Rose has really been struggling scoring the basketball, but he's still bringing the defense every single night. How important is it for you guys to at least have him give you one end of the floor rather than maybe putting that part
his
second?
His defense, I don't know what Bishop had at the half. I think he had 11.
He
had 11.
So, and he had 4 in the second half.
Yeah.
And that's Kyle Rose.
Yeah.
I mean, he's as good an on-ball defender as there is in the conference, maybe in the country. Now, the thing is, he's a good shooter, but that takes a lot out of you when you're working that hard, denying a guy 94 feet. So he's going to get his legs. I know this. Kyle Rose is going to go on a tear over a 3-4 game stretch. So thank God we didn't need him now, right? And let's wait till we really need him.
Assistant Coach Dave Paulson. Coach, thanks so much for taking
the
time.
Guys.
Congrats on the win.
Thank you.
That is Coach Dave Paulson giving some final thoughts here on the massive victory for Fordham over George Washington. It's now 4 straight. They find themselves now up near the top of the Atlantic 10 Conference, 85-70, the win over the Colonials. And Thomas, I just want to get your final thoughts here on the victory from Fordham here on their home floor.
Well, wow.
It's tough to say. There's a lot that happened in this game. And
This is going to be an interesting, dare I say, that this group is better than the 2006-17 when they were 18-12 and went 10-6 in the Atlantic 10. They were fourth that year in the conference. Dare I say that this group may be sniffing that older group, that they really have a lot of those elements. They're tough on defense, annoying underneath the boards. Now, they didn't really win the rebounding battle today, but they kept it close at 39-33. Offensively, though, it's a show on that side of the floor. Fordham, we talked about early in the year, is a little pedestrian, the Fordham offensive scheme, but it's really come alive here in Atlantic 10 play, and if it's going to come to life, why not have it happen now?
85-70, Fordham with the victory over George Washington here at the Rose Hill Gym. What a game. And Fordham is going to be back at home Tuesday night as they welcome in St. Louis. Another massive matchup there at 7 p.m. back here at the Rose Hill Gym. You expect the fans to bring that energy once again on Tuesday night. As always, that one will be on WFUV Sports. But final score from the Rose Hill Gym, 85-70, Fordham over George Washington. Let's send it back now to the Rose Hill Studios for the one-on-one post-game report with Colin Lockridge.
It's 90.7 WFUV New York. Listener-supported public media from Fordham, the Jesuit University of New York. On air, online, and always commercial-free.
The one-on-one post-game report.
Hello and welcome to the one-on-one post-game report. The Fordham Rams defeat the George Washington Colonials by a final mark of 85-70. Along with Owen Kelty, I'm Colin Lochran, here to break down today's contest. Momentum can move mountains. Khalid Moore hit a huge three deep in the second half to give the Rams a 58-55 lead that changed momentum from that point on and got the Rose Hill crowd jumping. It was showtime for the graduate transfer as he led the way all game long for Fordham and was a huge reason why the boys from the Bronx were able to grab the W and move to a 5-3 conference record. All told, Moore compiled 30 points, 8 boards, 2 blocks, and an assist. Darius Quisenberry also did what he could do, providing 22 points of his own on the day. Owen, momentum can move mountains. Prime example today at that packed Rose Hill Gym.
You know, it's exactly what we talked about at halftime. Fordham was going to need to step it up to get the crowd and keep the crowd in this game. And in the second half, they hit 7 three-pointers, and they held GW to only 3. And that was really what made the turn the momentum in their favor.
Second half numbers for the Rams. They outshot George Washington from the field. They outshot them from three-point range. Quite a second half from Darius Quisenberry. Not efficient at any time during this game, but just to get shots up. Consistently keep trying. Very important for that young man. And then Khalid Moore. So many big plays from Khalid Moore today. What did he mean for this Fordham team?
It was just an outstanding performance by him. The constant momentum swings that he was keeping with his dunks and just the play that he was just, he shot 10 of 14 from the field, 7-8 from the line, and he contributed 8 rebounds. So he was really contributing on all factors of the game, and he just kept them in the game, kept them close, and then let his teammates help him get better shots, get open, and just keep the game going.
Brendan Adams gave George Washington a team high of 18 points. It would not be enough. We talk about wins and what momentum can do. For me, Fordham has looked different since that LaSalle game where Antrell Charlton hit a last-second shot to win in Philadelphia. This one, another prime example of just things might not be going right, but if we can just hit that reset button, keep our cool, play with fire out there, you never know. This seemed like a you-never-know type of game where 1 minute George Washington is firing on all cylinders. The next, Fordham gets their act together. The second half just felt like an inevitability that Fordham was going to end up running away with this one, especially when Khalid Moore was started to play the way he did. The largest lead for Fordham was 16. George Washington's largest lead on the day was only 6 points. It did not feel that way. In the first half, it felt like George Washington was eventually going to run away with it, but Fordham ended up keeping it close. Then it flipped the entire other end of the spectrum.
No, especially like you said, in the first half, it felt like GW couldn't miss a shot. Everything they would take was going in. I believe at one point they were shooting over 50% from the field. And it was only a six-point lead, like you said, but every single time it felt like Fordham would come close or come close to taking a lead, GW would go on that run to get a back up to a six-point lead and just keeping that lead. And then it was the start of the second half that really momentum changed, and then Fordham kind of just took it and ran.
That momentum swing helped by some big bench contributions. Rostik Nowitzki, 10 points. Antrell Charlton, 10 points, 7 steals, 3 assists, and a board. Kyle Rose, perhaps not his finest day, didn't have any points on the afternoon, only 3 rebounds as well. Elijah Gray played some good basketball for the Rams, 6 points, 5 boards, very big in the absence of Abdu Simbila. Owen, before we let everyone go here, what are your takeaways from this big win?
I think it's going to be very important for the team, and just in general, the crowd, how important it was to this game, and just momentum going into their next few games. They can use the crowd. They can just keep things going. This is a big win for them, I think, momentum-wise and, like, for their team.
Fordham keeping up in the A-10. Once again, your final score is Fordham 85, George Washington 70. That will do it for us here on the One-on-One Postgame Report. The Rams will be back in action this Tuesday, January 31st. When they host the St. Louis Billikens in the Bronx. Be sure to tune in to 90.7 WFUV for full coverage. Tip-off slated for 7 p.m. on game day. The sports director of WFUV is Bobby Chaffardini. The in-studio producer was Brian Rabax. Owen Kelty took care of all the updates. And Maddie DeBelle worked on highlights. A huge thank you to Joe DeBerry and all his staff for their help this week. For Sam Davis and Thomas Aiello, I'm Colin Loughran saying have a great night. Fordham Rams basketball is a production of WFUV Sports.